Welcome back, ladies and gentlemen, to the RGN European Open Leisure Esports versus Excelling Esports. Again, Leisure picking up their map choice in cash. Was a little close in the end there, but they got the job done, 16-12. Now we're on to Excelling's map choice. They'll start on the T side. Of course, side selection going to the team who did not select the map. And we're going to see some aggression early here from the CT side, moving into the underpass area. And a lot of T's ready and wait. Get with the first one and the second. Sinks with the third. That's not the way Excelling wanted to start this, but recruiting, no, he's not left. He's gone. Hattrick, forget.
Forget. Man. Poor Excelling. The timing of that smoke worked out so perfectly for Leisure. The moment it popped, that's when Excelling were going to try to bust out. They didn't just charge the whole way with all their guys. And unfortunately, rushing through a smoke into two USPs, finding heads, not going to work. Maybe they could take this one following they have four spot, as is the standard nowadays. And once again, towards the tunnel sinks. Here's a lot of footsteps. And if Excelling's goal was subtlety, they have not accomplished that. There's going to be so much information here for Sinks.
Sinks going to get out of there, takes a couple shots, will eventually drop Raccoon. So early frag, and Sinks took a little damage, but not enough that Excelling's going to feel good about continuing up that real estate, heading back towards short water B. Sussested working out Monster. They've got Naviz to deal with. It's out of that pit area, Mire, off towards Graffiti.
Yeah, this Leisure defense.
Oh, man.
Looking vacuum sealed, chat.
Yeah, and that was... Nielsen decided to jump through that short smoke when JK and Gumkowski were already kind of routed back towards the squeaky door. So a little bit of misunderstanding there between... miscommunication between teammates or something to that effect. Only JK left.
I love the way Gett's playing this, too. Just guaranteeing it around for his team. He could easily, you know, play the spot where you peek both bathrooms as well as long, jiggle peeking back and forth, hopefully not getting caught, but get just peeks long. If they come into the site, the chance that they wrap around silently towards long to him is very low. So very safe play out of Leisure, exactly what you need to see on anti-eco. And at every point in the round, Leisure was ahead of them. Excelling tried to go tunnels, they meet Sinks, they try to make it up, fall back towards B. Leisure have it locked down, perfect timing on the nades, the molotovs, the smokes, and Excelling just couldn't find a window.
Sinks making his way into underpass here, get yet again finding more frags, and it's not a good look from Excelling thus far. I need to do some sort of economic damage here. Last round only finding one kill. Leisure would love to enter that first rifle round without losing too much. Get with one more. Does go down thereafter. Still only one frag on the round, and JK does have an M4 to work with. We'll see how this works, as actually quick on the flank here is Leisure. Not necessarily punished for it, though.
And just can't make their way out of the stairs. Gumkowski could have had an even number situation, but he got caught in one of those situations where you miss your first bullet with the pistol and then just spamming intensifies and then you just get wrecked. There was a trade there, but wasn't enough for Excelling. Now comes the big round. As Gumkowski, wonder what he's waiting for here. He's going to get a smoke. So tons of smokes here from the Excelling side. Only two flashes, though. So I expect a pick and roll unless they go with the B-Rush with two flashes. But either way, we're going to be seeing a picks attempted from Excelling rather than a straight execute.
So here they go. Two towards underpass. Sussested. Making some noise towards fountain. Some aggressive
also
long play.
Note, two times in a row now, Leisure on their first gun round, or on the first gun round, have gone for some heavy aggression.
Yeah, and that's exactly what I was just going to highlight there. Basically pushing way up long A, dropping a smoke down, and basically isolating that real estate. Eventually they do fall off of it, but yeah, aggressive play nonetheless. Got some a little bit of information on location of the T side, but quite a bit of time has passed. They are working a boost inside of A now, where Naviz can essentially watch short A. They're not worried about long, considering that intel they got earlier, but of course, more time goes by, might need to flip some focus back. But, Excelling, they're still kind of jockeying back and forth. They got three in A middle, two towards B.
Get spots one out, trying to jump peek into that B bomb site. Not going to go for it again. Just want to test the swiftness of Get. As Excelling now set up for the A bomb site hit. We have Naviz and Sinx over here. And they have a whole lot of T's coming their way. The smokes. There's a big gap. Is it intentional from Excelling? It looks like it was, but Naviz finds the immediate headshot and follows it up with a second one. I don't know how he got those frags.
Yeah, that was pretty nuts. Sinx doing work on long A. Found one as well. We'll go down to Gomkowski, and now we got a 2-on-2. Meyer and NKY. Gomkowski falls. It's only JK, and he's got players on either end. JK working the smoke, though, and that was a very nice 1v1 he just created, now lurking inside of the smoke, though, but Meyer having none of it. We'll put him down, and that'll be another leisure round. Expensive one, but only the first gun round now going the CT's way.
There was a gap in the smoke towards truck, and it looked too precise to be unintentional. I thought they did that on purpose, and they pop flash the player, I believe it was Nevis, playing that angle, just hugging the wall towards truck. Excelling was hoping that was going to be a free frag because they had that flash placed perfectly for that player. Nevis somehow fires full white at the perfect time and then finds another one after that. On top of that, at the end of the round, player gets spammed down through the smoke. Just one of those rounds in Counter-Strike where you could do the right thing, but it just doesn't work.
Yeah, and that's at the point you're at for Excelling. Very frustrating as, again, probably should have been around otherwise. And moving into this next one, they will go for the force buy. If you get that bomb plant the last round, they've got fairly decent equipment. Nielsen has assessed minus any utility, but it's Gomkowski to fall first, get with that AWP. He's now boosted up and actually does find a leg shot onto Nielsen in the balloons area. So lots of damage dealt here to the T side, and well, peeks again. And that wasn't Nielsen, that was Raccoon finding damage dealt to him, but very big advantage here, and Get doesn't look like he's done.
Yeah, I guess Raccoon's can't see too well in the daytime. His head was clearly exposed, but no frag for Raccoon. Excelling, really struggling early, as well as this round. And they're not getting any better. Like, Overpass, it's unique in the sense that it's every round kind of has two acts. The beginning of the round, and wait a minute, as I hold off my explanation, as Excelling rallies back with two frags, and now this opens up the map quite a bit. Now Leisure have to play 2-1. But again, the way they're playing at A, that long position, by not peeking it. Oh, he's not playing it the way I expected, but Sinx up to bat.
Yeah, Sinx just playing that cubby towards long A. And he's actually going to forfeit it a little bit. Finds the first spray down, suggested with the trade. So we'll be a 2-on-1. Quick to the bomb side is NKY. Naviz working the flank. There's got to be a little bit of time that NKY is going to have to buy here. Love to be able to keep tabs on Sucested's position, though. And it does look like they do still have that information towards long A. Sucested with the first, though, as it's only Naviz. Sucested slowly peeks the angle, doesn't recognize that he moved his way out, but a quad kill for Sucested, and excellent way to bring themselves right back, as it looked like a very bleak situation, but just keeping calm is Excelling, and they win the round.
I love the way Sucested handled that one-on-two. You see a lot of players crumble in that situation by not fighting for some real estate at long. That flash comes through, you'll see a lot of players just hug the wall and then try to fight out the one-on-two when they both peek together. No, Sucested is peeking, fighting for any sort of advantage that he can get. And you saw he created 2-1 versus 1s out of that situation, and I thought Excelling was doing a good job not allowing that to happen, but Sucested just played that so beautifully.
Really nice work there. Leisure not able to steal that round. As 4-1, immediate eco here from the CT side to know they're in 4 rounds in a row, but enough damage dealt that not going to have a buy coming in. That being said, Get finds one, makes it out of there only for a moment, though. Nielsen takes him down, trade by Meyer. So back and forth we go, and well, we got a 3-on-3 now.
And Sinx again. Might be the man tested. Excelling spread out with that bomb. This could be problematic. Sinx isn't peeking long, however, though, so doesn't look like they have any chance of losing the bomb there. As Meyer will go around to bank. What a shot from Sinx. And now he's going to peek long. Doesn't see the bomb immediately, though, and that's going to result in his death.
Very close play. Meyer can't get anything done at the Optimus truck. Now it's only Naviz. Hopefully he has found a Galil. He'll be moving his way up from behind. Immediate frag onto Sucested. That was a very nice shot. Only JK Crab walking out, and, well, aim punch. Navias can't get a hold of that control, and that'll be that. JK clutching the situation 4-2. That was not really good anti-eco from the excelling side, though. Only surviving with a single member.
Yeah, Leisure's making him fight for every inch at this point. Both rounds excelling as one has came down to a one-on-one. Can they keep it up? Big round underway here. No op for Get. And now excelling. See how passively they want to open up with this. Get, is he going to peak Fountain? This man is insane. He's playing it like he has an AWP.
And, well, he does capitalize, so makes it out of there. And excelling, going to be slightly frustrated. They gave up that frag, but now they got to work their way back. And again, going back to a couple rounds ago, they did work their way back from a very bleak spot. So down a player, not a huge loss for him, but will make things a little difficult. JK towards tracks at B, the rest of the T's towards A middle. And they can jockey back towards B through connector. We'll see if JK is going to gather some intel and might think about it. They still have a minute left, but they are slowly crawling up towards A. Sinks with a nice boost here at Bank Truck.
Not sure I like JK's position here. Okay, excelling is going to fall back towards the B side. NKY peeks up and spots the player at short, but he only sees one. See if the rotate's coming through from Leisure. Yeah, Nevis has made his way over towards the A side. Leisure still unsure where exactly this take's going to be, but it will go towards the B side. Three coming from short. JK coming out from Monster here. If he could just find this entry, it'd be huge.
So here we go. Sucested onto NKY. Meyer still alive in the pit. Naviz chimes in. Sinks as well. And they've lost control of the bomb. JK falls. Sucested is not going to be able to make this work. Runs away with 14 hit points. It's going to be the round, so tried to make it work there on B, but shut down by Leisure.
They tried to jockey back and forth from A, but I think the jump peek by NKY, spotting out the player at short, kind of threw a monkey wrench in the plans, as he wanted to stay quiet for that time for his teammates to come back. Now 5-2, excelling. Is it a single save? Their money is so destroyed. What are they going to do here? Sucested down to 650. They don't get it. Yeah, they're just going to force. I think this is the right decision. It's because they probably want to even out their money. They know Leisure can't have an economy built up just yet. And another B attempt. The last time they went here with pistols, it was not pretty.
So there is a boost underway. And as they're trying to work it, this might be the time. Okay, luckily Naviz is on point. Takes down Raccoon before any real estate is given up. They were trying to work that boost, and looks like I'm going to slow it down a little bit. Incendiary falls. JK was thinking about heading short. This is so split up right now, Laser. Yeah. I don't know how this is going to work out.
That's what I'm talking about with that like vacuum seal defense at B. They isolate both Monster and Short so well. The timings of their Molotovs. They had a Molotov up right when the take began, splitting the two players off of Short, forcing the players out Monster to either wait or commit. Two versus however many CTs are rotating in. And then they had another one right when that one faded. It's just the timing of the nades via Leisure. It's just like the post-plant scenarios on their T side. They seem to have them at the perfect timing. Now excelling. They've moved their way back towards Monster. And now they're going to split up. They're watching the flank, but if Leisure sent somebody on the flank in this 3-on-2, that would be insane. Now they go in with JK alone. Yeah, this is not looking good.
No, not at all. Nielsen trying to work his way out of Monster now. There's a Glil down somewhere in front of him. Sinks will spot him, though. He's got 15 seconds to try and make this work, but we'll be able to take down Meyer. So the first one, but Get from up above. Not going to allow him anything more than that. So Leisure just furthering their advantage. As, yeah, just like you had highlighted, I'm a little surprised that excelling doesn't adjust to that. The short players could clearly see there's fire down, but the monster players still decide to commit. So there's one thing to be split up by something that you can do nothing about, but I feel like communication probably could have solved that.
I think it was just due to their own limited utility. They just wanted to commit, and it's a really hard decision when you get split up like that, because Are you going to run through the fire with your short players? They don't want to do that, but the monster players also don't want to commit without those players being there. So the communication has to be really tight. It has to be all or nothing. Everybody goes or nobody goes. And we saw what happens when they get split up. P250s save Sosested the Rebel, and that's a nice kill on to Nevis, leaving only one player at this B bomb site with an op. This is dangerous.
This is very dangerous. Can he come up with another highlight? He gets two of them and misses the no scope. Luckily, Nielsen was pretty much widescreen. And that'll be that. Get with the USPS in the end finishes it off. Quad kill.
And that's what I was talking about, those sticky situations with Get. When your feet aren't necessarily planted, he sees gets those kills. And that's exactly the situation Excelling wanted. That opening to the round couldn't have been any better. On top of that, the player inside of the A-bomb site, the only man left inside of the A-bomb site, had an op. And that's exactly what you want to see if you're rushing him down with P250s. But Get comes up big anyways.
Yeah, now Get aggressively into that underpass area. Loves to work that angle, apparently. And, well, we do see a trade. Sinks onto Sosested, traded off by Raccoon. We'll be a 4-on-4 and Get plays to get out of connector right as that smoke dissipated. I'm sure that that was planned, and well, it worked very well as he will hit Gumkowski through the wall there, takes down JK as well. Misses the second shot there on Gumkowski, but still lots of damage dealt and only two T's remaining.
Somebody's got to check this guy for oil. He is so slippery. I don't know how he got out of there and almost burns to death, man. This guy is insane. Not only with the shots, but just the way he plays. You have 5 HP. Fall back. 8
right.
HP for leisure.
taking a tick from that Molotov. This man is either so aware that he's confident to make those moves, or he just does not care at all. And just, well, sure, it's a mixture of both, to be honest. And just, it creates a very aggressive play style, which, to be fair, works very well for him. 17-4 right now.
And he is going to go for a fountain peek again, it would seem. And he has a lot of targets. I wouldn't be surprised if he just keeps re-peeking it. And splits the defense, or splits the offense, or he shot between his two targets. And trying to rush him down is so sested. But he's all alone. No dice for him. Now Excelling tries to go back towards long, but Get, he's just going to keep peeking.
Yeah, indeed. Finally, he gets shut down. Kind of pincer in the washrooms. But Navi's towards long A ends and spoils the fun. Get just doing some crazy stuff there. As we are now moving to round 12. Another buy situation from Excelling. First, they need to figure out how to deal with Get. And then there's an entirely new scenario where actually winning the round is the next kind of step there.
But yeah, it's the opping style that we're seeing here from Get. It's kind of like the JW or Shazam, if you will. It's so crazy, and you're not used to seeing that, but I'll hold that thought as leisure. Pushing 3-man strong into the fountain. Excelling had numbers to match, but the nades just too good from leisure.
So early on, 4-on-3, Nielsen, he thinks getting aggressive towards A might work out. Get onto JK at B, and they're just so split up at this point. You saw kind of, again, Nielsen and Raccoon kind of splitting, parting ways right before they lost their third member, but I'm going to group up back towards B. Oh, Meyer, though. Taking down Raccoon, only Nielsen pops open Squeaky, will take down Get. Surprised it wasn't attuned to that one. Usually he is. As Nielsen heading towards B and does not have the bomb in his grasp, and Meyer actually just lurking on top of it.
We got a chance here. Nielsen, he knows this guy's somewhere around this bomb because he was just in the bomb site. But look at this. Leisure once again. How do they have these? And they have a smoke
so
up on NKY
aids.
Still. How does he get the bomb here? Answer, he doesn't.
Yeah, no, there's no way. NKY still has an incendiary, but not going to require it. Meyer takes Nielsen down, even if he didn't. There should have been a trade in effect there with NKY in position. And out of the round, double digits here on the CT side for leisure. As again, they took map number 160-12 on their map choice. This is Excelling's map choice. And with two rounds on their T side, needless to say, it's not going well.
I think this is a good timing for the pause from Excelling, too. Maybe they could have taken it earlier, but this is the point where they say, hey, we got two rounds. Anything more, and we have a chance. Other than that, if we don't get any, well, our CT side has to be perfect, and you leave yourself no room for error at all. But back to the opening of Get. It just, when you can wield the weapon in that style where you kind of break it in the sense where you don't, you're not using it like you're supposed to. You're supposed to be posted up with that AWP. You're not, like, not aggressively taking all sorts of peeks, kind of like Shazam or JW. It adds that unpredictability because at any moment, you could just switch it up and go back to playing passive. And that can create problems for the T side trying to deal, preempt, react to your aggression with that AWP. But I just love seeing that style of op.
Yeah, completely agree. Get has been on a tear here. And yeah, just to further your point, you're going to use a lot of utility on that T side to try and just put him out of position. He's peeking fountain every single round. If he's peeking under path, he has been peeking pretty much anywhere.
last round he was boosted at Graffiti.
The man is all over the map and excelling. They got to do something about it. But as soon as they make an adjustment, again, like you had stated, could just go back to that passive look on Get. And well, then it's just a whole nother ball game. So we'll see what
The most frustrating thing, because it kind of freezes your T side, because at any moment you can't really set up for a strong execution. Maybe Get shows up when you're trying to take into that bomb site. And then do you burn nades early trying to take positions that could be used later on in the round, just trying to figure out where Get could be? On top of that, Leisure's been aggressing with some of their other players. We saw, I think the score was like 7-2 or something like that, where it was Excelling had to save twice, and then they went for a slow play towards the A side, or just trying to get control of Fountain and Long, and Leisure, just like their first CT side gun round, go for aggression, because they know what's at stake for the T side. They can't afford to lose the round. Leisure, they can. So it's like, okay, let's just go hardcore for some aggression. If it loses, whatever. If it works, well, we're just going to run away with the map.
Yeah, and I think that's a really cool way to go about it, especially like you had stated, in a position where it's not as big a deal if you guys drop the round, but for the other side, well, you're going to make them even more frustrated and put them more into that hole that they're kind of slowly sinking into. So again, very curious what to see, what we'll see from Excelling out of this.
I'm playing a lot of poker recently, so I'll just do like a poker analogy. I mean, if you're playing heads up and you have a massive chip advantage, let's say like 3-1 over your opponents, you can go for risk. They can't, because at any point, there's a lot more at stake for them. And that's what we're seeing here, Leisure versus Excelling. And I love the way Leisure exploits their position economically and on the scoreboard. And they've been doing that across the maps.
Yeah, and to be fair, I'm saying like this is a tactical pause. I think their team speak did crash. I don't know how much strategy they're actually going to pull out of this pause. That could have been all just technical work. I'm sure they're utilizing some sort of communication
hopefully
to talk about things.
The last thing that anybody wants to hear is just use in-game.
Right? Yeah, that's
a wrap.
That's not a good situation to find yourself in, no matter how good the code is.
Everybody has that one teammate that just wants to use in-game, just wants to play.
Right? They're like, it's not that bad, guys. No, it's pretty. It's pretty bad. Anyhow, here we go. Excelling back in action. Hopefully their communication software is sound. And what we can see yet again, JK off towards tracks at B. And the rest of the players working towards long A here. And they may have found the opening they're looking for. Sinks goes down in middle as well.
This is exactly what they need. And Get goes down. They know that's the two A bombsite players down. Are they just going to straight up commit? Ooh, JK on flank duty goes down. NKY with the hold on the bombsite. Spamming down the second player. The player from bathroom can't find the trade. And that may lose them this round. But down to a 2-on-2. Still no bomb plant.
Meyer coming up from CT spawn. He's got Naviz with him as well. They're looking to get aggressive, though. Naviz finds the first. Nose Raccoon was hunting for him, and that allows Meyer to come up from bank and end the round. Excelling. Everything going their way until, well, they make it up long A, pushing. And again, one pop flash. One play that was perfect by, I believe it was NKY that threw that flash. Flashes just one player long A. Fights the guy who's not blind, and then finishes off the one that is. Just, again, excellent work by him.
And just shot to the heart for Excelling. Yeah. I mean, that was their chance. Any rounds that they could take. I mean, if they can even get four here, that changes the landscape of this match. It doesn't look like they're going to be able to do that, though. They know they need four, so they're just going to force up here. Might as well go for the last two instead of just going for three. At that point, you're still, if you lose pistol around, you're done.
Get is so aggressive here. They came up connector and they saw him in party, but only his backside, and he did make it towards Fountain, but now loses that AWP. So wanted to be a little bit more effective there, but to be fair, in a bad spot, he still gets one.
Right. He just wants to party. The guy's everywhere. He just wants in on the action. So Cested finds that Fallen up, brings down NKY. Now we're at an awkward position on the map with the players, is everybody between each other. But is Leisure just going to save this? It definitely interesting position with their money. Only going to get 1500 on a couple. Yeah, I guess they have to save, actually. So Excelling, if they could take this next one, that next one changes everything.
So here we go. Cested will fall, trying to find these guys. And actually, they will head on over towards B. Meyer just sprinting right now. He's going to drop a smoke under the bomb. He's just going for it. He's sticking it right now. But they will be able to find him inside of the smoke. But that was very interesting. Very interesting. And it was fairly close to working. Maybe not too close. But still, I like the style points, you know.
Right. I mean,
got to count for something.
Meyer has a brass pair to go for that kind of play. Molotov.
That was awesome.
Molotov. I mean, in his mind, he's like, I'm a genius. I'm a Molotov off monster. I'm going to hop on the bomb. He can't peek me because we'll be in the fire. Unfortunately, Ninja defuses. They don't happen often for a reason.
Yeah, unfortunately. Well, fortunate for Excelling, to be fair, as they're on three. Get peeking monster at B. Gives JK a look that hasn't seen, and well, I don't think he's peak monster at all, to be fair, but that'll be that. First frag on the way, NKY to follow it up, and Excelling, I'd hate to say it, but back to a losing way. It's just not looking like a good situation. Sings finds Raccoon through smoke and underpass.
And I'm thinking about it. On a map like Overpass, I didn't get a chance to fully explain. There's kind of two acts to every round when it's played at the highest level, and that's what gives it uniqueness in comparison with the other maps. Is the beginning of the round is spent, both teams will press towards the bathroom area, and then it's kind of a puzzle to solve from the T side, and then you mix it up constantly on your CT side. Maybe you'll play too long, two in the bathrooms, push down, fountain. The beginning of the round is played out, so the T side has to try to clear that. Otherwise, it'd be so much information for the CT side. And while I'm saying all this, is Get. He could just run amok while the T side is trying to fight for that information. And constantly switching up your position is just great.
Yeah, it works out really, really well as we've been shown. As, again, we are at half here, second map. Do want to, again, highlight the giveaway that we got going on. Jeremy9000. Up the Desert Eagle Golden Koi. It's a stat track one as well. So if you guys want to get in on that giveaway, head on over to Twitter, follow at GoRGNTV, as well as at Spy_Jeremy9000. And you'll see right on the RGN Twitter, there is the tweet that mentions that stat track Deagle. All you need to do is retweet that after dropping those follows, and you are good to go. The winner will be announced on the 14th, so good luck. Make sure you guys enter that. Special thanks to Jeremy. Here we go. Second half going live. Leisure, if they can take Pistol around here, could be a short evening for themselves.
This map isn't as CT-sided as it used to be, but still. I mean, if you pick a map like Overpass, you have to be prepared to get shut out on your T side and have to rally back on the CT side, and Nielsen doing just that. Everybody hitting heads here from Excelling so far. Nothing but headshots, actually. Navi's last guy up with too much to do. And Excelling, they give themselves a chance.
Yeah, very nice B side hold on the pistol round. So now they mount that comeback. And, well, we'll see if they can deal with the pistol armor buy here of the T side. Leisure without the bomb plant. Of course, again, very standard. Just go ahead and buy. Sink's actually going with the Deagle armor. Actually, we've got three Deagles on the field. Man, I'm just counting them as I see them. Get without armor. But we'll see if he can utilize that phrase. My other op is a Deagle. I think that's how it goes. I want to get a shirt like that.
Okay. They got three Deegs and they're just rushing. Screw it. Or screw the meta. We're just going to rush with Deegs. Not the most accurate of weapons while running. And they do get the opening kill onto Gumkowski. But Cested wasn't peeking long, and now he shows back up. And now the bloodbath begins from Excelling. They're vicing them in. There's so many positions. Leisure is just stuck.
Yeah, this is not looking hot for him. Get All alone with his eagle, finds one head, looking for a second. Still haven't taken him down just yet. He's got 63 hit points. He's trying to hold a close angle. They have finally got onto the bomb here. Successfully, you can see, just crouching, utilizing a squatting technique there, making sure that it's not an easy headshot. Just get did peek out yet again just to take him down.
Damn quads.
Right? Leg day.
Leg day. What is that? Actually, I have no days. I haven't been to the gym since like high school.
I think a lot of, well, I was going to say a lot of people probably on the same page, but a lot of people probably on their fitness kick right now. It's early January. They'll give up in about a week or so, you know?
Man, I'm at that spot. I want to get back. I want to sign up for a gym and everything, but I know if I go, it'll just be such shame and embarrassment via how out of shape I am. So I have to like get back into minimal shape before I go for that membership. But I'm just not there, Chad.
That's fair. It's understandable. I'm going to see a mow down here. Well, a bit of one. Naviz and NKY still left up with some damage, but Raccoon onto Naviz. No damage dealt onto that CT. Leaves NKY in a difficult spot. He does have a FAMAS to work with. But and time. That's about it, though. As provides a nade down towards Squeaky. Gives away his location a little bit. Bit of a safer peek into that kind of water short B area. JK actually is lurking down below. I'll actually test his luck back towards A. We'll see if he can find a quick pick and maybe a bomb plant here.
Now, problem being, even if he gets Nielsen, I don't know if he'd expect Raccoon to be at long as well. Not going to see that scenario pan out. But excelling. Now comes the next big hurdle. I suppose the Force Buy is a big hurdle as well. So, third hurdle. It's going to be the first gun round. And they still have a Famas out on the field. But the op is out for Get. And now, does Excelling have anybody like Get? I know JK uses that AWP, but I don't think he's going to be as mobile as Get was.
Yeah, we'll see if Get kind of makes this map his playground on the T side, similar to how he did on that CT front. I imagine we'll see that being the case, but NKY opening up, takes down Sesested in underpass. Gunkowski is still there, and considering how low NKY is, be wise if he didn't aggress any further here. But Gunkowski, of course, very interested in taking that duel. Actually, eventually just dumps an aid down, and well, that's the end of the life for NKY. Raccoon onto sinks towards long A. So they are going to take bathrooms control here on the CT side. Problem is still long A control here for Leisure, and they wait for Raccoon and eventually capitalize.
And the Bees just spotted out a player going into the stairs. Is this going to alter the plan from Leisure? Nobody's going back to the stairs, and they know the flank is en route.
Oh, Gumkowski spotted Naviz, though. He spotted his heel for like a split second on short. This just got really weird.
Yeah, because now both players know where each other are. So both teams are going to think that they have the upper hand information-wise, but both teams know. It's like playing, everybody has their card showing.
Yeah, that's exactly it. Well, Meyer finds one on long A, but Naviz falls without getting a lot done. Does have a one-on-one to take, but very quickly the flank coming in, Nielsen, or sorry, it was Gunkowski on the flank. We'll be able to drop him in the end, and excelling, just keeping that streak alive, four in a row now.
This is looking pretty good. Like I said, when you pick a CT-sided map like this, you have to be prepared to have a few rough T-sides and have to rally it all the way back on your CT side. And that's what we're seeing so far from Excelling. Leisure going to go for a B hit, so it would seem. Naviz has the Molotov. Probably going to throw that towards the barrels. So four towards short. This is going to be pretty bad. As they have the boost, now come the nades. And sad times for Leisure.
Yeah, here we go. Three left up. Naviz does find Raccoon. Created a 2-on-3, and they are getting the bomb down here. Isolated. I don't know. That's the part I'm missing, but we'll see. NKY lands one deeg shot onto Gumkowski right in the chest before going down. But that'll be that. They get the bomb plant. And again, I don't know how.
I suppose Excelling just want to play more cautious just to try to save those weapons. But problem being, I mean, they gave Leisure the bomb plant, which results in full utility for Leisure, the exception of Get. who's looking to continue his success with that AWP onto the T side. So another chance here for Leisure to try to put one on the board before Excel and get too much money built up. This time towards the A side. Excelling went two towards the bathroom right away. Now they're going to diverge. It's like there's a not a defined setup at the A side from Excelling.
Yeah, I'm just wandering a little bit here as...
Hey, man, boost me.
Yeah, that's what it looked like. You can literally see them asking each other. That all just transpired in front of us. Pretty funny stuff. So Sested, we boosted up at Bank Truck. Again, Gumkowski. It was leg day previous, now shoulders. Just gotta get him boosted up on his shoulders there. Alright, we'll stop making the fitness references. Everybody's mad at us because they're neglecting their fitness goals right now. And we're making them nowhere.
Gumkowski sounds like you're just a stout guy. He's just well built.
It's true. It's true. He like performs in those I'm trying to think, strongman competitions. Gumkowski, that's the kind of guy.
Yep.
But here Magnus. Yes. It is going to be an A-side taker, potentially. If it goes Leisure's way, Gumkowski, though, having none of it. Two frags going away. Make it a third. As Sested onto Meyer. Only Naviz left, and he'll put Gumkowski down. Follows it up. That'll be the end of the round, as Excelling eventually find their foothold yet again. And, well, they are putting up a hell of a brick wall here on their CT front.
Yeah, I think we're beginning to see why they picked this map. Three rounds can be enough on your T-side. As long as you have just a stellar CT side to follow it up with. Now, another gun round here from Leisure. Going to try to get it done without full utility, which you got to buy with this amount. And for the Excelling's economy, looking okay. Not the greatest, but looking okay. As we have Leisure creeping ever so slowly and silently. Up short, door is opened by Sested, and his head is gone. That's a big pick.
Yeah, massive pick here. Gumkowski still in connector. He's going to try his luck. Spots out Naviz. Can't find it on the first peek. Repeats. And we'll go down to Naviz. So, Excelling. They've built it all the way back up here, but now in around 5-on-3. They do have a bit of economy if this goes sideways, but JK and Raccoon really need to get a little bit more done here. If they're going to lose the round.
They need to just strip away a couple more weapons. Just a few more would change things economically coming into the next round. And JK probably not going to make it out of the bomb site. He's just going to go in for it. Again, just a few more kills from JK, and that would be excellent. Doesn't get it, though. And now Leisure. You can see what that does for their economy. Now, even if they lose, they can buy. So not the objective Excelling wanted. After going down early. And this is for the match, Chad.
Yep, here we go. Excelling draining their economy. They got nothing left in their bank accounts. Everything coming out onto the field here and now as deep waters and overpass. At the moment, Naviz going to be taking that position towards tracks and B. KY. Good about working underpass, actually. I think he just dropped a nade. Yeah, dropped a nade and then got out of there. Raccoon early frag and onto Get. That is a massive player to be taken out of the situation.
That's so ballsy by Excelling to go for that and to follow it up. Wow, this guy likes to duel. Sested takes another fight. Two plays back to back. If you're from the Leisure side's what? He's full white. This guy is absolutely nutty right now. This is incredible. Sested keeping it up from the long. As I was saying, back-to-back plays that you would not expect Excelling to make. Their back's against the wall. If they lose the round, they lose the match. What do? They push long. What does Sested do after they get the kill? He pushes again.
That was unreal. Crazy round coming out of Excelling. And one thing to note in the very end there, they were not interested. Sested walked right over an op. No one wants to play around with that on that CT side, and I like, got a feeling that they just don't want to duel with Get, but at the same time, interesting decision that they just want to keep all automatic rifles on the field.
How fast does Leisure go in towards B? Not fast at all.
Well, so
waiting outside a monster. But I think this is going to work out for the CTs better.
Ooh, Nielsen got a little bit aggressive there. as a nade from short kind of deals the damage that maybe he should have dealt, but he sinks on two Raccoon Leisure, creating a 3-on-3 here and getting the bomb down.
Like, oh, Myers Bernie doesn't exactly know where the Molotov is. So low. Oh, NKY goes down to JK. Both players now stuck inside a monster flank coming out from JK. Still a 2-on-2 here. Both now CTs on top of the site. Still a nade, but this Molotov from Gumkowski put it down. He's not even going to do it. Gets the first kill, though. Following it up is Sinks, but the defuse already happened. Sinks was banking on one of the players not being on the bomb. Instead, just both players peeking together, but he stuck it, and that's pretty ballsy in itself.
Yeah, definitely. Excelling on to take his last two rounds. Leisure, again, they had a very impressive CT side themselves, but only one T round thus far. Considering we're on round 25, they're probably feeling a little down if you're on the Leisure side. Fair, they're up a map still, but working that hard to get that many CT side rounds to let this one go. Not a situation they want to find themselves in. Holy nade, Batman. As, well, burning to death. Some of the players cleanses. As well. Yeah. That's Meyer and Get. And, well, they have created a 2-on-3. They've got a couple rifles to work with as well.
Oh, man, I'm so sad I missed my chance to say Meyer on fire.
Oh, boy. Too that bad. Would have been a good one.
Wait for the double kill. One damage from that nade only. JK's position exposed, but how do they get this frag? They can't take one bullet.
So, heading into connector, they've got JK from behind, and he is dropped, but the spam from Nielsen. The plywood is enough to deal with Meyer. Get with 4 hit points. Just to find some immediate headshots. Just kind of commit to the bomb plant here, and that wouldn't be the worst idea. Looks to go for the frag, but Raccoon takes off his head in the process, and getting close to tying things up here, 13 to 12.
I'm trying to think what's the right move here from Leisure. It's just that Excelling has looked so solid on all fronts. Even if Leisure tried to go for a fake to say, Excelling has been so unpredictable at the beginning of the rounds, kind of like that Act 1, Act 2 I was saying earlier. What's the move? Leisure getting stairs control, but Excelling getting so much information out of long. How far do they push up is the question. Oh, JK goes down, and this rotate is ages away.
Yeah, I think he was just jump peeking as well. Nielsen falls, and that's going to be the bomb site here. Like you had stated, no real rotate. Well, you got Gumkowski, but he takes a fight immediately, and only a 1-for-1 in that position. Needed much more. Raccoon and Sesested. Well, Sesested has had some pretty highlight plays, so see if he can make something work here. He is rotating in, so they will go for this. Navi's going to be the first line of defense towards Raccoon on short. That Raccoon actually caught with a nade out. He's only Sesested, and at this point, I think he's just going to cut his losses, head back towards the other bomb site and save.
I'm going to go for exits towards CT, though. A dirty angle from Sesested. Seems like Navi's has an idea, however. Blinds himself. Or that Sinks who blinded himself. solid play. And Sesested gets another one. And that frag right there changes everything. Leisure really needed to have a better measurement of where they're at economically. I mean, now it changes the dynamic of the drop. If Leisure lose this, then their economy is pretty busted up for the end of the game. And again, we have another round where Excelling, winner, that's it.
Yep, so here we go. Used to having their backs against the ropes, apparently, but we'll see if they can make this work. Excelling with some aggressive play towards middle. It's Raccoon. Finds an early op frag and a second one onto Navi's. He's got more to deal with.
What a
third
shot.
Before getting downed. Get and follow it up with 2 frags, but huge triple kill from Raccoon.
Right? It's like Raccoon. Body switch with Get. Nerd references, Chad. NKY and Get. Last two up. They're going to go towards long. See what Excelling decides to do. They're grouped up towards stairs. Now, normally in a 3-on-2 like this, you don't go for, speaking from the Excelling vantage point, you don't go for any more picks in this scenario, but they're grouped up on stairs. Now they split up. Now they're playing 1-1-1. I mean, I would much prefer them to just to play 2-1, at least guarantee one trade, but This could be problematic for excelling. If the A player goes down, all of a sudden Leisure has a big advantage.
Yeah, this really comes down to JK as he's positioned towards bank. He's going to provide a pop flash as well. They know exactly where that came from. As, again, he's working from bank. They get the bomb set. But JK not peeking aggressively. Just going to hold on to his position. Molotov gets dumped in his real estate, though. And that's going to allow... Ooh, NKY is chasing him. This is a crazy play as he sprays down one. Get follows it up. It's only Gumkowski as it's a one-on-one.
NKY, that was brilliant, but Gumkowski not gonna stick it. NKY forced to come out, and Gumkowski hits the kill, keeping excelling in the match. NKY just didn't buy it. And Gumkowski hits a critical shot, but I gotta say, instead of playing 2-1 in the 1-1-1 like that, the way JK played it, I guess you don't even have to hold the bomb site. You could just wait.
Yeah, he basically just hung out, provided a little bit of utility, and still, the way NKY played that, just rushing the Molotov down and making that work. Brilliant, but the bomb, again, being planted on the opposite side and Gumkowski on the flank, just couldn't make that work in the end. So excelling, one round away from tying things up, and they got an eco ahead of them.
Let's check what the Leisure's economy is like. If they don't get the bomb down here, their economy, they're not going to have everything. Their utility and Gumkowski. Here we go. How many is it going to be this time? Only one for Sessa to follow it up. And he's good for two. But still a bomb plant here for Leisure, and that's all they wanted.
Yeah, that's great news for them. As they'll have more than enough coming into the next one. Nade from that CT stairs area. Naviz takes a lot of damage. 2-on-3. Yeah, that didn't work out so well. NKY with the deep. Finds one head. Looking for a second here. Raccoon on 50 hit points. This is a little worrisome.
I believe.
Playing a headshot. Oh, boy. The jumper. JK goes with the Tech 9 flyby and, well, makes it work.
That's both kills from JK were in the air. CSGO.
Oh, the aerial route. Yeah, go for that. And there's probably some achievement out there for aerial attacks. Just going for it.
And this game, if I may be an old man for a second, when the right play is to go for the jump shot, come on.
Yeah, makes things very, very interesting, or lack thereof. I don't know, one of the two. Depends which way you look at it, as.
Or I shouldn't say right play, but a very viable option.
Yeah, it's definitely not a silly play, no doubt. As, well, 14-14, round 29 is live. Leisure, you've allowed excelling. Well, excelling's been doing a lot of work, so it's not exactly allowed them, but... Make it all the way back here, and Raccoon with an early frag onto NKY Leisure.
Wow.
Wow, right back at him. Get onto Nielsen. Falls to JK. But it looks like they're interested in furthering on to B here.
Wow, Leisure is playing like Molotovs don't exist. Get this time the man who just runs through it. How do they get this bomb down safely, though? This is Excelling's chance to utilize a big advantage. No, they're just going to wait it up. Try to take it safely. As it is a 4-on-3 here. Another big Molotov coming up from the water. Excelling's turn to run through the fire. They're pretty staggered with this retake. But Raccoon, first frag onto Meyer. Naviz and Sinks left. Smoke up for short. Sinks coming up massive for his team. And now Naviz just looking for the defuser. He hops off the bomb. But he's still going to get the defuse. Naviz just couldn't finish off that first frag.
Yeah, that was very close. And the way they both pulled off of the bomb, you can see that smoke dissipating. He was holding his crosshair where he had thought someone was sticking the bomb. But again, they both come off of it and kind of strafe to the side. And it's enough that luckily for the CTs, they didn't line up or anything crazy like that. They made it very difficult for that remaining player. And 15-14, now fighting for overtime here is Leisure. One round to do it. One round for Excelling to push us to Dust 2.
On to D2. I'm jealous of all these maps weather. I don't know how it is in Vancouver, Chad, but it's right. Below zero here.
It's not that bad, but yeah, I feel for you, bud.
Why did my ancestors settle here? Anyways, last potential round of map number 2 here. Excelling fighting to bring it into map number 3. And Leisure's play, we're going towards long. Unfortunately, Gumkowski is jump peeking it. So there's going to be a lot of intel for Excelling to try to get this rotate off fast, and they need to get there quickly.
Yo, Sing spots out Sussested, can't find the immediate spray down, but followed up by NKY. And Gumkowski tries to push long A. He had a huge amount of success in a previous round that way, but this time they shut it down immediately. But 3-on-3, Nielsen and Raccoon I'm going to follow this up. Get playing directly on the bomb site. Massive round here. Nielsen at Optimus. He's going to provide some spray into that first smoke, but JK falls to Get. Nice tap from him as he goes up onto the box and sprays down all three. Get is out of control, and, well, we get overtime here on Overpass.
34 and 20. Get out of here. That's ridiculous. And I guess he could do it with all weapons. And similar style to the way he does it, too. Just, do I have an HP bar? I don't care what it's at. I'm just, I'm going to try to shoot you before you shoot me. And he's better at it.
To be fair, that's not a bad way of playing, in that some players, if you get such low hit points, in theory, you have the skill to peek out and get an immediate headshot, but you might be hesitant because of it. Maybe Get just like tapes off that portion of his monitor. Just like, I never want to know. I'm always going to take the exact same peeks no matter what. And just
It's my biggest pet peeve with newer players, anybody who's like minus a year. When you go down low HP, or like people just go into a defensive shell and somehow think that, oh man, I'm Get right. I'm just gonna lurk over here while the rest of my teammates get wrecked. I'm not gonna go off onto this tangent, but I'll just say I'd much rather prefer an extremely aggressive player over an extremely passive player any day.
A fair assessment. As just waiting for these players to ready. Overtime in 2016. Wondering if we get just as much overtime in 2016 as we did in 2015.
Not a chance.
No.
There was that streak where it was just spooky. There was
no doubt.
Every other match was overtime.
Wondering if that will ever come back or not. But definitely. If you guys missed our broadcast last year. Had. Maybe not near like the later end as much, but definitely during the midst of the year. So much overtime was ridiculous.
that 2 month streak, or two, 3 months.
Yeah.
Just probably more overtime than the rest of the year combined.
I'd love to get those stats. At some point, we'll have to go back through, just look at our SIVO stats.
Are you going to do it? I don't know if our budget's big enough to hire somebody for that, Chad.
I'll figure something out. Don't worry.
So, you're the IT guy. Let's get some automation in there.
Right? I'll see what I can do. But moving into overtime here, I'm curious how this is going to play out. So excelling, of course, massive comeback, losing the first half 12-3, bringing it all the way back 12-3 on their end. Have to give them a bit of, well, they lost the last round, though. And I don't know how much weight you put on that, but I've got a feel that when you're at the place where you're about to close it out or you're about to push it to OT, the other guy takes it, or the other team takes it, you're probably going to lose some momentum there.
I still think excelling is going to be okay mentally after this one. I still think they're in the advantage here. If Gumkowski doesn't go for the hero play, then we have a 4-on-3 in that last situation. But how well it worked out last time, he's thirsty over there. So I still favor excelling. If they don't make those few mistakes and they go back to what was working for them, get a better spot onto long. They went with a B stack, or not a heavy one, but still, on that last gun round. And here we go. First OT of 2016.
Here we go indeed. So we got Raccoon with an op. Interesting. So he's actually saving a bit of money. He's not buying any utility unit, which that's actually, I don't know if that's the first time I've seen that over time, but it's an interesting way to go about it. But Get finding Nielsen. It's going to be an early frag, and actually follow it up. NKY with two. And that's the B-bomb site. Just completely stripped of control from the CTs. Raccoon and Success did almost in a save scenario. It's 2-on-5.
That was a really ballsy play by Nielsen. He goes to the other side of Monster. Even if your flash is really good, there's just some timings that work out where that player is going to be able to spot you, and he just doesn't make it there safely. It wasn't like there was any follow-up play from excelling onto that push. It wasn't like they're going down short or anything. So if he goes down, suddenly you're at a 5-on-4 or 4-on-5, and the main strength of that excelling defense over towards the B side, in my opinion, was this the timing of their nades. And when you're down a man like that, that changes everything. And he wasn't even going for information. That was he's committed on the other side of Monster.
Considering how many T-sided rounds we saw in regulation as well, it's a massive round to pick up for Leisure. Again, only three for either side, and you start off overtime where you only get three on either side, you pick up the first one. Definitely a fantastic start. Lots of confidence in that T side now. Whereas on the CT side, well, you got to stop the bleeding. And what is going to be their answer to that quick B take? Do they decide to put more players there, or do they decide to get aggressive elsewhere? We'll see. Raccoon actually goes for that middle pick, but doesn't go his way.
And Leisure are going to go back to the long play. This is what put them into OT. Raccoon, boost me here. No, let's go back here and go over here and boost by the bank. And the timing's bad. Raccoon, he's in danger. Oh. His head is exposed, but he gets out of there.
That was so close. Luckily, he finds NKY, but a lot of damage coming in his direction. Sesta, though, will follow up. Meyer and Sings taking down two, but Kowski will take down Naviz. So 2-on-3 advantage to the CT side, but not in the form of the bomb site here.
And Sinks just went off the top, jumps into the CT stairs. Unfortunately, somebody is waiting for him down there. But that could have possibly went the other way if they could have just taken the head off of Raccoon. Because it took him a little while to get that boost up near Bank, and that was a big opportunity for Leisure. But one round could easily be enough here.
Yep, so here we go. Get that AWP in his hands on the T side.
Mike Goldberg's going to sue us, man.
Why?
Here we go.
Oh, here we go. Right?
Sponsored by Bud Light.
Yeah, he's probably, not the happiest, but that is quite all right. We're using it for good reason. It's a nice phrase. Open things up as it is a B-side focus here for the T's. He's assessed jumping and trying to peek over on top of that plywood. Get a little bit of intel here, and have a lot of nades raining in. No execution as of yet, though. But again, considering they've allowed Raccoon to come all the way behind them, I think B is their target.
And this is what I'm talking about. When it's 5-on-5 like this, okay, Leisure is going to get a chance to set up and execute, but now comes Excelling's timing with their nades.
Oh, this is why
it's so impactful to have 5 up.
Raccoon whipped so hard, Laser. That was, he had a free heal to the bomb carrier, and now it's a T-side advantage as they breach into B.
Oh, I wish I could have saw it. Critical error at the worst of times. And now Gumkowski, 5 HP. And this is, if he could pick this up, I mean, he needs to pick this up in my eyes. Excelling, they only got 3 rounds. He can't do it. Single bullet's going to do it. Sinks onto Gumkowski. I'm so sad I missed it, Chad. Those are my favorite moments to look at, is when somebody just fails so hard in an actual match format. It's just like watching a comic bomb or something.
He was on the stair set behind the players going out monster. He had basically vision of 2 players heading through monster. He could have picked either of them, shoots right between them, one of them being the bomb carrier, and he had a second chance as he re-peaked, but he got killed before he could take the shot. So it's just massive advantage being thrown there, and that definitely could have been the round. And unfortunately for them, they're gonna live with that painful memory, or at least Raccoon, who knows. The rest of his team were alive at that point, so he could probably just be like, I just got killed. Nothing bad really happened, but when they watch that replay, they'll know, Laser.
They'll know. It's one of the ones you... Let's just not review this demo, boys.
Yeah. Forget that round. Nah, it's fine.
So Ken Excelling, with the number of rounds that they have... Oh, that's a big pick. Get shut down. And that is a message to send. Sesset has had enough of that nonsense. And this changes the dynamic of the CT side now. Now that Get's been shut down by Sesset, that's a lot of confidence for Excelling. And Get was the problem. He finished at 34-20 in regulation, but Leisure, right back.
Well, they do find a couple frags. That was a little bizarre. One of their players, I'm uncertain which one it was, to be honest with you, but one of them decided to push up to A without any assistance, very low as well, with, again, like 10 hit points. So no trade or anything close. Yeah, you gather a little intel, but now it's a 3-on-3. Lost the player advantage. And they do have a minute. We'll see if Sesested can find anything more here. Naviz just playing alone at the moment on this A bomb site. NKY is in heaven, so a quick rotation, but see how this one plays out.
And Naviz, he's not peeking A at all. And in this situation, it's so tempting to try to go for some information, try to buy some time for your teammates to rotate by peeking, but Sesested was ready for it. Switching it up, though. Excelling back to the B-bomb site. Meyer pushing up towards Monster. This is so big. Gets Gumkowski, and he's going to be able to get out of there. Drops a Molotov. He's now looking at short. NKY has already arrived. Sestested has dropped the AWP. Gone in favor of the M4, but how does he get the bomb down?
Wow, just planting right in under the open. He's just going for it, and he gets it down. NKY doesn't peek in time. He flies down from heaven and drops. It's only Naviz, and he's hit him to 50 hit points, but that'll be the round of the end. Sestested almost making that work. That was an unreal round from him, to be honest. To start it off, frag on to get, and that was through a smoke when he was trying to boost over it in balloons to follow it up to the... Yeah, just crazy round.
I'm pretty sure he was senile. Soccer coach would say, good hustle. That was
good hustle.
almost. He almost created something out of nothing there. And he realized, okay, I have no real chance of getting the bomb down safely. If I take my time and try to, you know, juke back and forth a little more, probably going to get wrecked anyways. Let's just hope he rotated out of heaven. Plants in the open. Genius.
I can't believe that worked out for him on one-on-one, but we're going to see Get back to peaking Monster with his AWP, and we're going to see JK sitting there, and, well, he goes down, and the bomb was almost fairly near to him. Still back towards T-Spawn, to be honest, so excelling. This is looking like a pretty broken round to start things off, especially with that frag, and now Sestested has to go all the way back, and he was one of the front runners in those last rounds.
And Get just back to his normal self. Oh, I was that Monster. Now I'm long. He's just everywhere. And it's so problematic because now you're Nielsen. He's looking for an AK or a M4 to fight over here. And the way he's walk peeking, it suggests that. You don't walk peek an op like that. And Get's just making himself omnipresent.
So one player left. Looks like this is going to be the end. And indeed it is. 19-16 Leisure. After having second half go to overtime, they had a very impressive first half, but got very close in the end. Excelling, though, can't close it to push it to a third map. So that's going to be that. Leisure moving forward in the round of 32. So good news for them, as, again, just starting that European Open. So we do have more matches for our European Open tomorrow. As, let's see here, HD4R versus Public Clear. It's going to be at 1 p.m. EST tomorrow. So hopefully you guys can tune in for that. But we do have a match tonight as well. It's for our Winter Classic 2, $10,000 prize pool there, North American region. So Lunatic Esports is taking on Incursion. So that's at 8 p.m. EST. So hopefully you guys can catch that as well. But you can follow myself on Twitter at Sprawl. And at Laser Jesus as well. And like I was stating, we got that giveaway going on. Make sure you guys get in on that. Jeremy9000 giving away a StatTrak Factory new Desert Eagle Golden Koi. So follow at GoraGNTV as well as at Spy_Jeremy9000. And retweet the specific tweet that you'll see on the RGN Twitter page referring to that deagle. And the winner will be announced on the 14th. But again, guys, we are done for our European broadcast. Hope you enjoyed. We'll see you next time.